Stop sleep is anything sleep alarm for drivers who may be operating a vehicle while they are drowsy. This device attaches to your fingers. It can detect when you begin to get drowsy or tired while driving. It will then alert you 5 minutes before you fall asleep, ensuring you are always awake and alert to changing road conditions while your vehicle is in motion. This device has been scientifically tested by the NCSR and is recommended for use during any road trip. It offers a super fast charging time and can be used for many hours, even if you are not prone to getting sleeping while driving. Thus, it's a great device to have on your road trip. Long hours on the road could be taxing on any of us, and you may begin to fall asleep without realizing it. This device will make sure that you and any passengers remain safe for the duration of the trip.
Welcome to Compu Ghana. We are widely renowned providers of all computer-related products, software solutions, mobile devices, electronic gadgets, and home appliances. Our showroom houses world-leading brands such as Samsung, HP, Dell, Lenovo, LG, Surface, Cisco, Microsoft, Canon, Bluetech, Sencor, among many other best brands. Visit any of our showrooms across the nation or call us on 024-314-3143. You can also log on to www.compughana.com to shop. Compu Ghana, passion for technology.
International Community College is an ultra-modern primary and secondary school that runs the Cambridge International Program. It's a day and boarding school stretching from the preschool to A-levels, and we are guided by a strong foundation in ethics and Christian morals. At ICC, children get the opportunity to engage in interesting activities such as ballet, taekwondo, swimming, music, basketball, football, just to mention a few.
We give our students the option to travel outside Ghana to explore limitless opportunities in other countries and to broaden their knowledge based on cultures, technological advancements, and international mindedness. The school has developed and is running an efficient online learning system where students interact with their teachers through the adoption of online learning platforms with our use of state-of-the-art online tools.
Visit our website at www.icc.edu.gh to learn more about us. We also look forward to your on-site visit to experience a serene learning environment awaiting your ward.
There are few in this country who know who we are. We are a club which celebrates achievements. We are a club which embraces participation. We are a community club, creating great memories. Proudly putting the team before oneself. Together, we are creating our own legacy. We are
You have a wish list of home improvements? Do you have a growing to-do list of repairs and maintenance? Are you overwhelmed by contractors specializing in only one area? Every homeowner has a to-do list and a wish list. Both are important, and you deserve a handyman that can get the job done right the first time. No job is too small or too large. Our U.S.-trained handymen handle all your repair and remodel needs quickly and professionally. From plumbing and electrical to air conditioning, carpentry, masonry, you name it, we will get it done perfectly. Contact us today at www.kbfsystems.com. KBF Handyman Service. We do it right the first time.
there, and welcome to another episode of your favorite tech show, TechTV. Today, we're discussing tech in a restaurant, Bistro 22, to be exact. I'm sure you're wondering. Come with me. Hello. How are you doing?
I'm good.
This is the first time we're having a female guest on the show.
Oh, really? Oh, I'm so excited.
You're our first. And I'm really, really glad that you're actually the first, because now it opens way for many more women like yourself to also come on the show. So tell us a bit about yourself, Debbie. What do you do?
Okay. So my full name is Deborah Domakanobala.
Yeah.
And a native of the Northern Ghana. So most of my education in Northern Ghana. And finished in 2016 with a BSc in Financial Mathematics from University for Development Studies.
Hey, the sharks!
So I proceeded to AIMS Senegal, AIMS African Institute for Mathematical Science, where I completed with a degree in mathematical science again, and then came back to Ghana and then pursued another master's degree in machine intelligence with the African Institute for Mathematical Science in Ghana.
Okay.
And I was sponsored by Google and Facebook. I did this concurrently with MPhil in Applied Math in Ken UST. I completed this year. So at the moment, I lecture with Academic City University in Accra, and I also work remotely as an NLP engineer. That's natural language processing engineer with a company in Canada called Proto. And what I do on the side, I'm the co-lead for Women in Machine Learning and Data Science Accra Ghana chapter. So these are the things I do.
Impeccable resume. I mean, if our women in Ghana have a resume such as yours, I mean, why isn't Ghana progressing? So you have an entity, Women in Machine Learning and Data Science. Can you tell us a bit about that?
So Women in Machine Learning and Data Science is a non-profit organization.
Mm-hmm.
So they actually have the headquarters in New York.
Yeah.
So it's an international thing. So we have chapters all over the world. And so for Ghana, in particular Accra, we started this chapter just late last year, so with two other ladies. And our main mission is that we want to get more women and people or gender that are less represented who have an interest in machine learning and data science, or want to learn machine learning and data science. So
yeah.
We are sort of trying to create like a niche for them. So I mean, you have to have a sense of belonging. You know that, okay, you belong to this community.
Yeah.
You can get to them, learn from them, network, and grow as an individual. So this is our main mission.
What are some of the things that you hope to achieve within the next 2 years or within the next 3 years?
First of all, what we hope to achieve would be that I hope that when I enter any tech industry, and let's say we have probably like a team of tech people in the company, like let's say they are 10, at least we should have 5 to 6 of them being women.
Of course.
at the moment, trust me, we have very few representation of women in most of the tech industry, and it really saddens my heart.
It saddens me too. I told you, you're the first female guest we're having on this
show. Imagine. And you have been running this show quite some time, so I expect that you should have had at least, at most,
is it that they are women but they are hidden, or They are not there?
They said, you can't be who you can see, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if I am a woman and I see a call for application, Women in Machine Learning and Data Science, I'm a woman and I'm interested in data science, I'm interested in machine learning, surely I'll quickly just go and apply. But now let's just say we tell you training into machine learning and data science, just there.
Mm-hmm.
There is usually some fear in most women that, okay, when I go there, I wouldn't pick up fast, I'm a slow learner. That syndrome in you, imposter syndrome, you're like, you're not good enough, you can't learn fast, makes you stay away, and you don't want to put yourself out there and say you don't know something.
Yeah.
And that is what we as women in machine learning want to do. We want to create that niche so women can also feel comfortable.
Exactly.
To ask questions and then feel free to say they don't know things and be talked. I've had talks with friends who have told me that they go for interviews and their CVs have been shortlisted. Maybe, you know, most of these foreigners, when you hear their names, you can't tell if it's a male
female or a male.
Right?
Yeah.
So they go for the interview, they think this is a man. prepare the CV.
Then
you come in and they say, ah, you're a woman? I mean, if
why should
I am
that
the
be
one,
a surprise?
Exactly.
I mean, let your CV speak for you.
If I am the one, before I even get into the technical interview, I would have lost hope. Even everything I know would have been gone.
Yeah.
So I think that awareness, people should make it a norm that, yeah, women can get into tech, women can get into STEM, and be open to receive them.
You know, traditionally, Ghanaians are used to the simple topics, the simple subjects, like English, like literature, like social studies. So when someone who doesn't even know much about the topic wants to even go into the topic, they're a bit scared. They're like, hey, data science, it sounds so strange. What is data science, and how do you actually help in getting rid of the notion that it's such a scary monster that no one needs to go to?
Data science basically is an interdisciplinary field that deals with making insights out of data, mm-hmm. to be able to make informed business decisions. So basically, if you're given data, what kind of useful information can you get out of this data? And once you get the useful information, what can you do with it? Mm-hmm. How is it going to help your business? If you're someone who wants to get started in data science, as far as you have a domain expertise, maybe let's say you're a health worker, you're a nurse or a doctor, the only thing now you need is to get your math, computer science and statistics. So with computer science, now largely we are looking at the programming part. So there are different programming languages. We have Python, we have R, we have Java. Mm-hmm. So pick one of them and begin to learn. Mm-hmm. And I think that everything under this planet we can learn, provided we want
to. We are dedicated to,
right?
Exactly.
So you know what you need to be able to work with any health related data. You don't need the whole of math. You just need some particular topic.
So you need to pick a niche, sort of. If you study a topic like data science, you're wondering, where does that put you? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So there are so many roles you can get into once you study data science.
Can you
first
kind of
say all,
some of the
data scientists, of course.
data scientists.
So we have data scientists who are well paid. Though in Ghana, we can still talk about that, like the jobs are not forthcoming in relation to those roles. But I know that there are a lot of remote jobs in relation to data scientists. We have data analytics, we have an AI researcher, we have a machine learning engineer, and we have, of course, an NLP engineer who I'm also an NLP engineer,
yeah.
Right? Yeah, so these are all open roles that you can get into, and they are somewhat similar depending on which company you go to and what they are looking out for and what their job description is. They'll probably decide to give it a particular name. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but most often, data scientists is what you can find in most companies, mm-hmm. especially remote jobs. You have freelance data scientists where you just go do people's projects for them and then you're paid. And as a data scientist, you do some analysis. Mm-hmm. So someone would rather call you a data analyst, mm-hmm. but you're doing some analysis in data science as well.
How can somebody watching get involved in the Women in Machine Learning and Data Science if they want to?
So we're looking to have more women, right?
Yeah.
So if you want to be part of us, we have a meetup page. You just simply have to join our meetup page. You can check it, meetup.com. So just search for Accra Women in Machine Learning and Data Science.
So it's meetup page, so
meetup.com, right?
And then you search for Women in Machine Learning and Data Science.
Yeah, Accra. Okay. Just add Accra because we have different chapters.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, so you just join us, and whenever we have an event, we usually will just put it on the meetup page and people will just register to attend. Then the registered attendees, we follow up with the link to the event or mm-hmm. more details if it's going to be a physical event, right?
Are there fees attached? Do you have to pay something?
No. That's the good thing about us. We want to reach out to more people, so your financial background shouldn't be a hindrance. So we are open, so you can join any of our programs, any of our trainings. And that means that when we're having training, sometimes we'll be coming to bigger or larger corporations to help us with support.
Yeah.
So that those participants coming wouldn't have to pay. So if you're a large organization out there, look out for us. If we come knocking on your doors, please listen.
Government
to us.
Entities, especially who are interested in digitalizing the economy, these are some of the entities that you should be looking to, you know, for support, because they need your support.
Yes.
I mean, we're talking about STEM in Ghana. Mm-hmm. These are some of the people who are pioneering or pushing forward STEM in Ghana. So please, we are creating awareness for women in machine learning.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's been really good having you on the show, Deborah. I learned a lot. I think I was very, very keen, especially on what you said about data science. I didn't know particularly. I mean, I had a fair idea. But, you know, just before we go, I want you to touch a little bit on big data. So, basically, I know big data to be... let me give a practical example so for our viewers out there. I was scrolling online and I was searching for a pair of shoes. I think I was searching to buy a pair of shoes online. And I don't know, I mentioned it to a friend. For some reason, I don't know, but I was scrolling on my phone and then I saw an ad for the exact kind of the pair of shoes I wanted. And I was wondering, is it that my voice is being recorded? Is it that the phone was able to pick up what I had said and was now showing me ads based on the conversation we had? So is that big data? Does that kind of like, is it not a bit intrusive? I don't know. but can you just talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I think that has become the norm now. So this, what you saw is something we call recommender systems, mm-hmm. right? So what happens is that you probably searched for something related to this. Mm-hmm. And so it's already saved in your feed. So what happens is that a recommender system works such that when you search for anything, this now bring things that are similar to what you searched for. Just like Netflix. Now you have Netflix recommendation.
So it's like an algorithm thing.
Yes. So usually they, you know, these things are clustered.
Yeah.
So let's say that if you watch a movie like How to Get Away with Murder, it's more of law stuff.
So it gives you,
they put all of those movies in a cluster. So you have How to Get Away with Murder, you have Suits and other movies, mm-hmm. all in that cluster. So once you watch it and then you show a 5-star, like, yeah, really, I like this movie. Yeah. Surely they would recommend a movie like Seal to you. And when you watch it, you'd be like, this movie is so nice.
They'll recommend another.
That's
one,
what they do. So these are recommender systems. So it's a form of machine learning we call unsupervised learning. So basically unsupervised learning is that you have inputs, but you don't have exact labels or targets.
Okay, so thank you so much, Debbie. I mean, it's been so fun having you on the show. I'm ecstatic to have a conversation like this with a fellow woman. You know, viewers, I'm sure you learned a thing or two today. I especially learned a lot about machine learning and data science. Don't forget, TechTV is proudly brought to you by CompU Ghana, KBF Systems, Chase Sporting Club, and Philip IT. We're going for a quick commercial break. Don't go anywhere.
Welcome to CompU Ghana. We are widely renowned providers of all computer-related products, software solutions, mobile devices, electronic gadgets, and home appliances. Our showroom houses world-leading brands such as Samsung, HP, Dell, Lenovo, LG, Surface, Cisco, Microsoft, Canon, Bluetech, Sencor, among many other best brands. Visit any of our showrooms across the nation or call us on 024-314-3143. You can also log on to www.compughana.com to shop. CompU Ghana, passion for technology.
International Community College is an ultra-modern primary and secondary school that runs the Cambridge International Program. It's a day and boarding school stretching from the preschool to A-levels, and we are guided by a strong foundation in ethics and Christian morals. At ICC, children get the opportunity to engage in interesting activities such as ballet, taekwondo, swimming, music, basketball, football, just to mention a few.
We give our students the option to travel outside Ghana to explore limitless opportunities in other countries and to broaden their knowledge based on cultures, technological advancements, and international mindedness. The school has developed and is running an efficient online learning system where students interact with their teachers through the adoption of online learning platforms with our use of state-of-the-art online tools.
Visit our website at www.icc.edu.gh to learn more about us. We also look forward to your on-site visit to experience a serene learning environment awaiting your ward.
You have a wish list of home improvements? Do you have a growing to-do list of repairs and maintenance? Are you overwhelmed by contractors specializing in only one area? Every homeowner has a to-do list and a wish list. Both are important, and you deserve a handyman that can get the job done right the first time. No job is too small or too large. Our U.S.-trained handymen handle all your repair and remodel needs quickly and professionally. From plumbing and electrical to air conditioning, carpentry, masonry, you name it, we will get it done perfectly. Contact us today at www.kbfsystems.com. KBF Handyman Service. We do it right the first time.
Welcome back from the break. If you just tune in, you're still watching Tech TV, the only show about technology and science in Ghana. Next is Passion for Technology. Take a look.
Yeah, from it, Kwame Nyako. Yeah, we Sunyane, Ghana, Sunyane, Bonafo. Uber to my friend, a black engineer. The entire from a black engineer, yeah, me, yeah, maybe, me, a far electronics, any computer, mobile apps, and any sound man. And on a million tier, this engineer, man, black engineer. Na me yan ema bebre me ye solar tracking system ye inverters and di jesi ano ye car app ana ma develop and di wo de maka na otim operate wo car no through mobile phone my history be maka we and di me baba demonstrate a chere se na ado ni si ye adwuma me baba so car na alarm no wo phone no so di se me di alarm na to on alarm na ba on and di me be bie car no kono na hwese the battery ga. I can't tell my giant, the alarm not to offer the
alarm
is off. What are to offer? I'll be in for you. And this is how you should be. I'll see ya, mama. I'm going to be alarm automatically. Yeah, call central lock. No. Central lock. No, no, I do so. Is there a central lock on no, that? A down lock. Timmy, the two lock.
Two
lock. Once I lock it. And the central lock not to lock. And there's no way to be without the key. And the to unlock.
Door unlock.
Leaning out of the arm. Should in case I say, what would I have been messy? And you say, oh my, I'll be our office. Instead of a sort of a will have a piano. Over to my usual apple. I will hire the will have a piano. And you will say,
down.
And it will have a piano. And the office in a case of business in Suto. Number says, you will be one. Udimica, I don't know what's after that. And the who you should be
now.
And Robert will arrive at us. And then they will wear it down.
Brought down.
Up on ye.
Brought down.
The same time, Ebiana, officer also AC. And officer also can Ebiana heat a bomb. And the officer, Undurana or can actually. Or can actually, and Sana will do. And the, I don't know. Who is that? And once I will catch a canoe and spark it. We will do an hour so easy war. Undrona will be actually coming. I don't know. Would the ignition be to on?
Ignition is on.
My voice will start on.
Starter active.
I just so. AC is usually.
AC is on.
The AC now, so no. And Undrona actually. Wait, my awful AC is so high.
AC is off.
Opa so actually, I'll answer. I'll be on your mother's old duna. And once I'll acquire.
Ignition is off.
Can we do more?
Welcome back from the break. That was Passion for Technology. There are lots of young people out there doing amazing things. If you're an inventor and you want to be featured on the show, send us a message for our various social media handles at TechTVShow_GH. Next is safety tips.
Driver tiredness and fatigue is a killer on our roads. Too many rollover crashes and head-on collisions are caused by drivers falling asleep behind the wheel. Signs of driver tiredness include struggling to keep the eyes open, yawning frequently, and slow reaction times. A tired driver may also wander across the centre line and drift across other lanes, over road markings, or follow other vehicles too closely and have trouble remembering the last few kilometres. Stop and rest before it is too late. There is no quick fix or miracle remedy. Our bodies simply need to rest. Most adults need a minimum of 6 hours of sleep per night. When we don't get enough sleep, our brain cells do not communicate effectively, which in turn affects our visual perception, physical reflexes, and memory. For your own safety, always start your journey refreshed and well-rested. To remain alert and focused behind the steering wheel, plan your journey and your rest stops. After 2 hours behind the steering wheel, or every 200 kilometers, find a safe spot and take a break from driving. Stop, refresh your body and mind before continuing your journey. Let's share roads safely and responsibly.
Welcome back from Safety Tips. There are always some safety precautions to take when using gadgets. I was very ecstatic having Deborah on the show today. I'm sure you learned a lot, and I did too, about the Women in Machine Learning and Data Science program. As Deborah mentioned earlier, you can join their program by going to meetup.com and then searching for the Women in Machine Learning and Data Science. STEM is not scary. You just need the willingness and dedication to learn, and there are opportunities and resources available to those who intend to do so. As always, you can follow TechTV on our various social media platforms at TechTVShow_GH and catch a repeat of this program on Wednesdays at 11 a.m. on GH1 television. It's been fun hanging with you on the show today. Until we meet again, same time next week. Bye.